All right.
I found out what a lagoon is.
Yeah.
It's like a lake, but there's like rocks separating it from the ocean, so it's salt water.
Oh, okay.
Basically that.
Interesting. So it's like the...
So which means that they're complaining about the water being undrinkable because it's funny. It's undrinkable anyways because it's all salt water.
Oh. Well, maybe this greed of people like thrives on salt water. It just needs to be not muddy salt water. Ooh, Rondo one half, hard battle.
We'll play that
one day. Make that the fighter we play on two players, one controller.
The Saturday morning scrub lords.
Lagoon.
Lagoon. Not Laboon. Lagoon.
Laboon is a different thing. What was Laboon?
He was a giant whale.
Oh, right, yeah.
He had scars on his head. He was pretty badass.
Then he got a
straw hat logo. Knows him.
Phillip's
Castle. Continue.
Where the dreaded adventure of CDI Link took place.
Slapface, go.
And this is the room where Link wondered about Ganon's whereabouts. And this is where they bombed the Dongos.
Legend of Zelda tour group. Alright. I got
fire.
It costs 3 MP, so that's pretty good. Shame the knights are apparently immune to it.
Yeah, they give you magic just in time to make it useless, you said.
Yeah, well, against armor. That makes sense. Fire. Metal armor defends against fire.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You'd think it would just make it worse.
Chicken and tinfoil takes longer to cook because of that.
I think it just, like, trap the heat and, like, roast them alive.
Yeah, yeah. You'd think that the worst thing you want to do when going to hot places is wear giant, like, heavy metal, like, plate armor.
I'm so warm. Oh, God, that's the last stages of hydrothermia! Global warming!
So, here's a question. You think they're humans or monsters?
That depends.
Why are you raiding our castle?
I guess that depends on how they're animated. I mean, there was a...
Oh, shit!
He's the bad guy from Dot Hack, the second one.
Oh yeah, these guys are immune to, are weak to fireballs.
Roots.
Oh, Roots.
He was like a big panther dude.
Oh shit, he's fast!
There was that one character in Slayers, Nama, who's totally not Naga, by the way.
Okay, oh yeah.
Was a human.
Well, that's anthropomorphic armor.
Well, yeah, they were animated. Yeah. Animated armor, just like these
guys. Oh, armor! Speaking of which, we got gold armor!
That sounds very fireproof. And electric-proof.
Does it actually have a higher melting point than, no, that's the wrong one.
Steel type, not at all weak to fire type.
Well, yeah! Haven't you been paying attention to this conversation? Metal is weak, is like immune to fire.
Yeah.
Alright. Our defense is now up to 56.
That's good, whatever that means.
Means we can take... We're marginally more sturdy.
Every time I see the name Nasir, I imagine Spyro's voice, because it's just nasally.
I'm the hero, Nasir!
I'm the hero! So he's like 13 years old, so he has to wield a sword that's like... Or maybe like appropriate to his size.
Maybe it's a trope breaker, and he actually sounds like Chad.
And then
you got some giant guy with like a really booming baritone sounding name, Barry.
And now, he sounds like this.
Also, the reason why this screen takes forever to like move is because he's nearsighted.
Oh, okay.
I guess, going by that.
Just gonna explain all of the,
It's actually really deep lore that they integrated into the gameplay.
Yeah, yeah, that's it.
Okay. Also, the reason why he can recover so quickly is because he's got, like... Being a hero light enables him to heal passively.
Yeah, he meditates.
He's got holy blood.
He meditates and recovers half his health.
Yeah, he's got a touch of the divine in him. Alright. So this is a maze, again.
I thought about that as a, I was thinking if you had a very generic RPG. Something
like
very...
Like this?
No, this does some innovation, like the standing still and healing.
I like the fact that you like this game better than you like any FPS.
like, I don't know, like the first Final Fantasy, something like that, and you had an item that would enable this, just healing if you were standing still in the field.
Well, for most games, that would be, like, broken.
Yeah.
Because like, then you wouldn't need to go to inns or, like, manage your resources.
Well,
or
the
whatnot.
Thing is, if it were an equipable item, you could only have it on one party member.
Oh, yeah. Just make it but it just make sure you don't have any item duplication glitches.
Yeah. I'm just thinking of ways to make, like, really unique functioning items that aren't just, like, resistance to fire.
Like
extra
this,
defense.
But stronger. Like, oh, this sword is like this sword, except it's stronger.
Yeah.
I'm trying to think. There was this one game that I, wait. Are we close?
Oh, check how much EXP those guys give you. Before and after. Or just kill them.
Okay, so before.
488.
Up.
6. That's pretty good. The knights give you 5.
Yeah. And they're weak to, like, fireballs, so...
Yeah, so those guys are easy EXP right now.
Yeah. That one I can't open until I rescue the elves. Mm. Oh, is that a... You motherfucker, did you get a fucking, giant mech?
No, it's a buttermilk chicken.
It looks delicious! Damn it, I can't have it!
I had to wait 10 minutes for this.
It looks like it's worth every damn second!
Well. I got a McDonald's coupon I'm probably not gonna use that you can get buy one of these and get another one free. I'll give that to you.
Alright. I can't use it until a bit later though. The frame rate's dying. I need to kill some of these enemies to free it.
I do normally pronounce it coupons, by the way. I'm just saying coupon to be funny.
Coupon.
Before anyone thinks I always say it like that, because I have always been saying it like that.
Alright. Level 7. Alright, let's see if we can... Okay, I know... The elves are underground.
Okay.
I thought
that was hobbits, but okay.
No, they're elves. You want hobbits in this game? Fuck you, you don't get hobbits. I think. Okay, I have no idea where anything is.
Don't look at me.
I know that I... Oh, there's a way down here. There's a door that takes me underground. I just gotta find it, and then we're good. Due north, game! Ah!
That fucker!
I got ambushed! This isn't the place!
You're gonna have to do the follow the wall trick.
Yeah, okay, so we're here. So.
Follow the right one, that's what you've been following.
The one to Nasir's right or my right?
Nasir's right.
Okay. The up, facing up or facing down? Whatever, I'll just follow this wall.
Follow the wall on the outside.
Okay. Oh, wait, I didn't go down here yet.
Uh-uh.
Well, look, nothing. There we go.
You complain about enemies being able to stunlock you, but that also seems to be the most effective method against them.
Yeah, they don't seem to have... He's got, like, 2 little swords. He's like,
I'm gonna forklift you to death.
Dude, just, like...
He does look like he could be a pretty functional forklift.
I can't for... Oh. I guess this whole entire section was pointless.
Yeah.
Get out of my way. I guess I'm following this lower wall.
Yeah, that's the one you're supposed to be following.
Alright, so we're down here. Should I have, like, graph paper? I can map this whole area out. But then again, the proportions are so weird.
People used to do that back in the day. Remember Bear's story?
Bear's story?
In .hackstein. They're like, you old man, you used to map out the dungeons on paper, nerd.
Well, it's like back then you didn't have computers or like resources, so you had to make do. Wait a minute. Oh no, this is the entrance.
Just keep following.
God. Okay, then I guess we're going up.
No, you're gonna go right. Come at me, bro!
Ah! Something went faster.
Guy's trying to juke you.
Man, these knights. Okay. Not at level 7 yet. Those little knights are kind of weak. Ah. It's like trying to simulate random encounters.
Yeah.
In a real-time combat system. That's why the screen kind of takes forever. Okay, are we going up?
No, right. Follow the wall.
Follow the bottom wall, huh?
Yeah,
all
right. The right wall, the right of Nazir.
Okay. Dang it. Oh, there we go! Thank you, Xelrog. You are a great cartographer. Okay. Welcome to floor two.
Oh, it's yellow
it's like
now.
I would say brown.
With jellyfish.
Yep. So they kind of move when they want to. They're fairly harmless. I'm at level 8 now. 568. Let's see
are
how.
Are you following a wall again or just wandering first?
Oh. Let's probably follow a wall. That way we can get like to where we need to be. Okay, following the right wall. Outer wall, and then we'll. Okay, so 568. 574.
Fire, super effective against water type.
Yeah. Jellyfish. Silly jellyfish.
Fucking tentacles.
Tentacool or tentacool?
I'm not allowed to play Pokemon again this week.
Nah, you can't. We can if you really want to.
Well, I'm going to be busy the next 2 days anyway, so.
Well, I guess it gives me time to do whatever I want. Or whatever. Ah!
Well, sure, I'm not.
Oh! Oh!
Okay.
They're the wizards!
With robes.
There we go.
Yeah, I'm not going to be available. I'm never available in the midday, and I won't be available Friday night, so you do whatever you want.
Sure. I'll do it
with manly gusto!
Well, with great, trepidation, rather. You got any...
You haven't had a lot of successful solo streams.
No.
But that's okay, that's what practice is for.
Yep.
It's a learning experience.
Oh, I don't want to get in front of these fucks! Alright, I better chill and recharge. just, you know, waiting for my healing factor to kick in.
Yeah.
And, you know, my magic, whenever it is getting around to, there, we'll stutter step, there we go. Ah!
You just changed the wall you were following.
Oh, did I?
No, shit. You didn't, never mind. Forget what I said. Oh. You're right.
I had the wrong wall. Wrong wall. What?
I just remember another thing we talked about playing.
What?
Was the Tony Hawk games.
Oh, yeah.
Though we still have to decide if we're gonna... I guess we're gonna have to dig out either the Dreamcast, or we can play the PlayStation versions, but those ones kind of shitty.
You have Underground and Underground 2.
Well, yeah, but we gotta...
We totally do the story mode on those.
Yeah.
It's actually pretty fun. You get in some pretty cool pranks in the second one.
I don't have Underground 2, just one.
Ah, dang it. I thought I did at one point. I think we're getting close to where we need to be.
Yeah?
You know, this strategy. Ah!
Can your shield defend against those?
No, you gotta jump over them. There we go. I John Wick shot him.
Yeah?
I think I know where I need to go from here. No, never mind. This way. Yep. Okay, the elves I'm looking for are on like the top left corner of the map, so I just need to head over there. You can kind of find what quadrant. You kind of remember what quadrant everything is in. You can make your way to there, provided you can navigate the maze-like structure of this game. Alright, I think we're gonna go. Nope. I need to go down first. Maybe.
I mean, don't look at me. You stopped following the wall.
Yeah, I did. I kind of just jumped the gun there. Down then. God fucking fuck! Oh, I'm out.
That sounds like a Mario sound effect. I don't remember which one.
It's gonna be the first time this game ripped off sound effects. Nope.
You gotta squeeze the. This hole was made for me.
This is my hole.
Can't believe that was referenced on the Miiverse. Somewhere I saw it.
Yeah, and then I showed you the comic. Okay. Wait, was I wrong?
I don't know.
God! Man, I wish I had access to maps for this game.
I'm sure you could if you looked them up.
Yeah, I...
Someone somewhere...
What?
So it was the bottom left, but on an upper left wall.
Hey, guys! Oh, wait a minute. Did I need to grab another chest? Please, no!
Someone somewhere cares enough to have mapped this game.
I think I fucked up. I think I needed to find, like, another item or something. Please, no. I don't need to go through all that pain again. Come on.
Man, if only we were drawing a map.
Ugh. No, please! God, hey! I got the mantle!
Does this help?
Will you accept this? No, no. I'm gonna grab my laptop. I'm gonna see. Much as I want to enjoy this game and get through it without as much help as I can, I'm gonna need a map because otherwise it's gonna take way longer than necessary.
So how are you guys? I can do what now? Oh, okay. X's attack. That's jump. How do you magic?
Right bumper.
Oh, okay.
I don't know when I last saved, so you might want to save. God. You can't go diagonal, right? It kind of sucks. Alright. Oh, is that a chest? Is that what we need? X. Fuck it! Kill that guy!
Yeah.
Arr! Okay, now open the chest. Dang it, that's not what we needed. Okay,
I need to heal.
What?
I need to heal.
That's fine. You just sit there and then you'll heal. Cause magic. Okay, Lagoon. Map. Not in Utah! That's in Utah.
I'm in the field of spires.
Oh no! You say like I told you to?
I did.
Alright. Lagoon map. Game FAQs, you got any maps? You do have maps! I knew I couldn't doubt you. Alright! We're in the basement. You said we were at the spire pillar?
In the bottom left. You see those bunch of dots?
Yeah.
That's okay. Where we're at. That's where the chest is. You see
it? Okay, we're looking for... Oh, it's all the way in the first floor! Fuck! Alright, I'm gonna need to take control again.
Okay, there we go. Back to Jack.
So how'd you like the combat?
That was okay.
Alright. You were able to get used to the close combat?
I didn't do much of it.
Okay, let's see. Oh, that's just more gold. Gold is useless in this game.
Yeah?
Because you don't really need to buy shit.
Did you see that guy who commented on our Monster Girl Quest video?
Oh, which one in particular? There's a lot of
the
comments.
One I linked you to earlier today.
Oh, fuck. It didn't go straight to that comment. It was just like a bunch of comments.
Well, it was the latest comment.
What did it say?
He was talking about the Sphinx stuff.
And he
said he liked the videos, though. I'm glad someone gets our Slayers references.
Yeah. That's really cool. Okay, I see what's going on here. 100 gold. Don't know why we grabbed that. God, okay, look at this fucking map. This is a giant U-shape with all these branches. So here's where we enter, and then we go across, and then we go up all the way through, and we loop around and go down here.
So it's, that's where we're at, right?
Yeah, we're over here. So we started from here.
Well, yeah, they got to make it as much of a trek as possible.
God damn, that sucks. All right, let's just get out of here. And by comparison, the floor one map is actually pretty straightforward.
Do you want me to navigate?
No, I'm good. I don't want to make you do anything you don't want to do. No!
No, you gonna die.
Shit. No, I'm not. Oh! Oh, 6 HP! Yeah, I got him. I thought you were making the whack off motion for some reason.
No. Just scratch.
It's fine. Okay, so now that we have access to cartography, we can
wait and heal.
Yeah, sure. Now we have access to cartography. I know where I need to go. The maps are actually kind of decent too.
Yeah.
It's like the person who mapped these out is pretty cool.
Shout out to that person.
Would I recommend this FAQ? Oh yeah, FAQ FAQ.
I mean, that's what everyone calls it, game facts.
Yeah. It's because it's like, it almost sounds like facts.
Yeah.
Like F-A-C-T-S. Doesn't matter, I can go up here. Slap base.
Yep.
So, bottom floor is guarded by warlocks and jellyfish. I guess they didn't want to reuse the knights.
It looks like he's not moving because his head doesn't move in the walk animation.
Yeah.
Just floating along.
He's got very good posture. Well, we're getting close. I think.
Now we go all the way down again.
Yeah, well, first we go left, then we go down. Oh yeah, I designed a dungeon. No, that's too linear. We need to make it more complicated. Okay? Crew from Inception designed a video game.
Yeah.
Alright.
Are we here? Is this it?
I think one down. Oh, no. Wait.
Down one more.
I think we fuck it. Hold on. Run away from angry warlocks. Ah, you son of a...
And not the cool kind of warlocks who punch stuff in the face.
Oh yeah? You think you're really good at that? Well, I'm gonna punch you in the face. It's like a guy who's like, I bet you I'm better at you at Magic the Gathering than you are. Okay, turn one, Black Lotus, tap into this. Yeah? Well, I'm gonna punch you in the face.
Yeah.
Alright,
You're getting attacked.
Yeah, I know. Oh, he's slightly faster when he's locked onto me. I can aggro him.
Yeah.
Kind of. God! Can do this all day, buddy. Alright, that was good. That was easy. Alright, first floor. I'm at where am I? Oh, point one. All the way to the right. And the thing I need is... Okay, so down one, go left, past that, up here... Ah! Shit, that was a critical blow!
Is that a thing in this game?
No. I don't think crits exist in this game. I'm just like, he hit me more than once.
This game could use more RNG.
As opposed to this game, zero RNG?
Yeah, aside from the enemy spawns.
I'm pretty sure... Nah, the enemy spawns are pretty consistent.
in terms of like location.
Yeah.
This game has zero RNG. It is the most fair RPG you could possibly play, kind of.
Yeah.
Did I go too far?
Where are you going? Is it on this first floor or on the second floor?
No, I'm, here we go. I think I found it. I think this might be... No? Yeah, this is it. This must be the chest. Hi!
Guarded by Panther Dude.
Here we go, we got Key of Prison.
Good descriptor.
Key of Prison. We had a colon S before, but not Key of Prison's key, or key. Prison key. Key of Prison.
Key no prisoner.
Alright, point C was 200 gold. Point B was the gold armor. Yeah, we got everything from this floor. Alright.
So now down
now
to the
back
basement.
Down to the basement!
So that we can save the elves and then come back up to get to the second floor, right?
Yes. The second floor has another key. I think Philip's key.
Alright. Is this the very... No. Oh, no it isn't. I keep getting lost in this game. Where am I?
Even with a map.
I went down, and then I went down again, and all of a sudden... Okay. I'm confused. Okay, so up here, and then there's that guy that's point... So I go down here. Where's the exit?
I don't know where you're at.
I'm supposed to be over here. Is the exit just gone?
I don't think you know where you're at, because there doesn't seem to be an exit here. Go back
the
way you came.
Where the fuck am I?
Go back up.
Did I accidentally go to Gold Armor Point? No, what?
Just go left. Alright, whatever. I don't know.
Okay. Oh, okay, I know where I am now. I was kind of confused. So, I guess by the name of Philip's Castle, there presumably was somebody called Philip. Who lived here?
Prince Philip.
King Philip II.
No relation to King Philianel. Or Prince Philianel.
Key of Philianel. Then you have Lena Inverse's cape called Cape of Sorceress.
Cape of Pink.
Cape of Pink. I'll cast the Ball of Fire!
Remember when Philly and Al got famous for rolling balls up mountains?
Oh, that was cool. And I think, wasn't that the one thing her, like, his, like, daughter was just kind of like, really, daddy?
Or... No, she was amazed that how, like,
oh, wow,
amazing
daddy.
They respected him.
Daddy, everybody respects you. Okay, back to the fucking U-turn. How come your basement is bigger than both your floors combined? God, Prince Philip was not a good architect.
No.
Alright. Oh, you know what? He didn't even, like, post anybody down here. It just, this place just has a really bad monster problem.
Yeah.
I didn't expect the warlocks to ally with the jellyfish. God, these... Okay, I'm at level 9 now. Alright, that's good.
It's just a whole stream of going a distance, stopping, checking the map, going, stopping, checking the map.
I'm setting your bar really low, right?
Yeah.
It's so when I get another game out, you'll be amazed. Wait a minute. The fuck? Oh, I went up too far to the right. I need to go more left.
Yeah, so the Illusion of Gaia stream will be better?
The Illusion of Gaia is a much better game, considering it was made by Enix.
Mm.
Yeah,
was Secret of Mana Enix?
I don't remember. I'm sorry. Oh. I've never beaten that game, though, so I don't ask me to play it and be good at it.
Yeah.
Oh, God. So what other obscure RPGs do we know of, besides the one with the Gallant Hedgehog?
I don't know if Daydream and Davy is an RPG or not.
I don't remember either. I think it's not.
Da, 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 da. I can't think of too many. I like innovative RPGs. Like, my favorites are Battle Network, Pokemon, Paper Mario. Stuff with unique battle systems. But, I don't think I play a lot enough to know any, like, really obscure ones that no one's heard of.
Battle Network is pretty mainstream-ish.
It's well-known.
The Mega Man fandom sure likes it. Okay, I think now we're coming up on the Hall of Pillars, maybe? Yep, here they are. These glorious...
landmarks.
Fucking pillars. Key of Pillars. Alright, you ready to rescue some elves? Let's go rescue some elves.
Can you tell me who the final boss is? Like, a very broad, like, is an evil wizard? Is it a dragon? Anything like that?
It's a dark spirit.
Okay, that's enough.
I know this because they literally call it Dark Spirit.
Yeah.
As if that's its proper name.
Okay.
It's a...
Hey, look,
it's
Link.
A demon, I think.
Oh. Well, they couldn't translate it to demon because Christianity.
Yeah. What was the talk button next? What shall we do? Princess Felicia was taken away by a strange woman.
No, not the cat girl.
did you come here to save us? You brought the movable mantle, didn't you?
Yeah, here's your wig.
Now we are safe. I bet everybody's worried about us. Yeah. Well.
Sure are saved.
You guys are pretty cool, you know that? Well,
have fun fighting your way out.
What's the item but... What?
You're trying to give him the...
Oh, I don't have key of... I don't have the movable mantle equipped, sorry. I still have the key of prison. Well, here's the movable mantle.
That was the first guy wanted it, didn't?
By the way, we found out that this is the key to the stairs leading to the second floor of this castle. Thank you so much. Be careful.
Key of Phillips.
Key of Phillips. And they're gone.
That's some cool elf magic they got there.
No, they just took the movable mantle and... Cape of Teleport.
Oh, is that what it is?
Yeah, it tells you to... Movable mantle!
It looks like a wig.
It's a wig that allows people to teleport.
Okay.
It's like a D&D item.
It's a good wig.
Good wig. Great wig. Alright, now we can say goodbye to this basement because we never have to come back here. Look at how blue his cape is. This is a really cool cape.
Yeah, it's much more royal than the last one.
Yeah. So, I think Nasir's an orphan or something.
Yeah?
Like, I don't know if he has any kind of, like, family or anything.
Oh, why don't you ask him? Oh, wait.
You were the chosen one, Nasir. I was? The chosen to do what? Make the lagoon drinkable.
Yeah. It's a very important destiny.
Yeah, we'll go to...
Not just save the world, just filter the water.
Save the... No, I guess it's like... It's not the fact... The water's not muddy because demons are coming. It's just the tide's coming in.
Most underwhelming destinies.
You are chosen! You got a legendary weapon! Alright, what am I gonna do? The power's out. Could you fix it? Oh, that's the wrong way. Shit. I haven't saved in a while. I just realized.
Yeah.
Oh, dang it! He's not letting me go! It's all wrong. Most underwhelming destiny. Cannon.
I don't think you ever got to this point in the game, but these dungeons remind me of the underground in Gen 4 Pokemon. There's this just giant underground system of tunnels under the entire region. That all look identical.
God. Of course they look identical. Like, same construction planners, like, no, let's not differentiate these tunnels at all. Bill the Builder? Let's just, oh, this is the wrong way. Yep. Blind fire! my level at? I can get to level 10 before I get to the boss. No biggie!
You gotta go through level 2 before, or the second floor before reaching him, right?
Yeah, the second floor's enemies, I wanna say, aren't as hard as these floors. Like, I forget what they are, but I don't think they're as bad.
As the terrifying jellyfish.
The jellyfish. If you look closely, you can see that their fucking head is like a reverse question mark.
Yeah?
Since they're questioning their existence as to them being here.
Alright, back to floor one.
Floor one, more like
things make sense.
Ah! Fuck off! Okay, so, let me see. Alright, point one, we gotta go down to the very bottom, go to the start, and then go up a bit left, and then up again. So, this is actually... The first floor is the easiest to navigate because they actually put holes in all of, like, the walls.
Yeah.
Whoever designed this part of the dungeon is, like, actually competent.
It wasn't actually designed that way at all. Kenpachi just came here and broke all the walls down.
He was so pissed.
Remember when he smashed down a wall in order to grab a ninja by the throat?
That was
pretty cool.
Well, he was like, "Oh, Ichigo, there you are!" Just as he was being dogpiled by fucking everyone. Going left. And then he's like, and the ninja was disguised as like a little girl.
Yeah.
Oh, is this the right one, or did I miss? I feel like I missed. I'm gonna have to go back down. It's okay, we're gonna get to the boss soon, and then we can continue on with the plot.
Yeah. Next, we're gonna go to Sony Castle.
Key of Phillips. This is just
the staff of Walkman.
Sword of Nintendo.
That sounds broken.
Shield of Microsoft. All right, we're almost to the second floor. Are you ready to see the second floor? What do you think it's gonna look like?
Blue. That's my best guess.
Blue. Okay. More of a greenish.
Gray.
All right. I'm not fucking around with this part. Some of the jumps are actually kind of tricky. Hey, there's your blue.
Yeah.
I guess we're on the battlements of the ramparts of
outside.
Oh,
yeah.
Fuck. It's the Haunter. We're being attacked by Haunters.
Is he immune to sword?
No, I just didn't want to touch him. Unclean. There's nothing over that way. Ah! There we go. So it's we're at 845 now, and then the next level is...
970.
852. That's a 7-point increase.
Yeah.
That's gonna be a while if I take that route. Wait! This isn't a wall? This isn't a doorway?
You need 12 more enemies.
12 more enemies of that variety. Yeah. The other variety are just impractical to kill. Okay. So if I remember correctly, this actually... Yeah, I don't need to be here. Go up. That leads nowhere. If I need to grind, then I can do it here, but... In all honesty, I don't feel like I need to.
Yeah?
Because I remember the guy who did a speedrun in this game. He was at a really low level when he, like, first fought him.
Yeah.
And he was at a lower level than me. And the way you beat this guy is literally just get up to a good level and then out-damage him.
Mm. So was he able to beat this guy at a low level, or did he have to...
Yeah, he had to abuse the
boss's stupid as fuck AI.
Yeah.
This game has, like, very little AI.
Yeah. See, the enemies seem to be just charge you.
Yeah, the enemies have got one mode. Attack. Attack it head on. If that doesn't work, attack it head on. Which means these enemies are demons. They just care nothing but, like, killing you. Oh yeah, large shield.
No, you can't say demons. They're monsters.
Sorry, yeah, monsters.
Xelrog is of the monster race.
No, they said demons at the very beginning of the game.
I know. I was making a Slayer's joke again.
Yeah.
Because they wouldn't call them monsters demons.
So.
In English.
Yeah, that's true.
You should get extra damage for, like, the headshot you get from jumping and slashing.
Extra damage for jump slashing? That'd be pretty cool. How much does it improve every second?
What improve
two.
What?
So it's just increasing one, like, two every second.
Did that shield improve your healing?
It defense.
Oh.
I was just checking. I think the regeneration scales. Don't quote me on that.
Yeah.
Okay. So what's that point? Oh, 100 gold. We could easily skip that. So let's just go to the boss.
This is basically cheating, but as long as it gets through the game faster, I don't care.
Yeah. I just don't want to... It's not fun to wander around for, like, 5 hours.
Can't imagine it's fun to watch, either.
Even the greatest Let's Players use guides occasionally. Have you heard of Omicron the Nomad Soul?
No.
Well, it was a game by Heavy Rain dude David Cage, and it had input from David Bowie.
Yeah.
And from what I understand, it's a mess of a game.
Mm.
It, like, drove one person to temporarily quit Let's Playing.
Mm. That guy was a fucking slowpoke. It took him 3 shots to realize he was being attacked.
That's how stupid the AI in this game is. Alright, so this is the boss. What do you think the boss is?
Oh, fuck if I know.
King of Phillips.
It's Ra, the sky god.
King of Phillips. Ra, the sky god.
Yes, the sun god, Ra.
Alright, that's good. Let's fight this fucker.
Slifer, the sky dragon. Well, the dragon-like thing.
Chimera!
Lion dragon. Do you want the gold lion or the silver lion?
By the way, in case you're wondering why I'm just not using my magic immediately, that's because magic doesn't exist in boss battles.
Oh.
You don't have any magic. Yeah, that could have gone better.
A little bit.
That's, So he does... He initially... Immediately does... That! Oh wow, he just shredded the fuck out of me!
I think you lost an arm, he might have bitten it off.
Okay, what am I supposed to do then? I guess get in and back off? I really don't want to have to grind.
Stand the right distance back that he won't quite reach you.
Oh, you can just leave! Really?! You can just do that?!
Keep respawning this enemy and getting 7 XP.
I got 80 defense, yet he's still taking me apart like tissue paper.
Can you imagine if you could walk in and out and in and out of the Ganondorf fight in Ocarina? Come on, Link, let's do this!
That'd be pretty impressive. Ah! See, that fireball hurts. Okay, here's what's fucking with me. Yeah. This is where, like, you not having any pixels to, like, hit really fucks with you, because if you touch them, you just take damage.
Yeah.
So... Wait a minute!
He took 0 damage.
Oh my god! Oh no, I gotta grind! Damn it! Fuck this game!
You're just not dealing enough damage?
No, I'm not dealing any damage!
You're at just that level?
Yeah! I talked about this before, right?
Yeah, you did.
How the game's, like, leveling curve is fucked up? Alright, what's the power we got?
See how much those guys give you.
Okay, so I'm at 908. 914.
So 6.
As compared to the ghoul's 7.
I wouldn't say they're totally not worth fighting.
Yeah. I just don't want to go too far.
Just enough!
Okay, and then I go back. And I go frontwards. There, I pull out my gun!
Now I'm in the closet.
So they take three fireballs.
Three fireballs, the other guys take four. Yeah. Fuck if I know why, but that's the decision they made with that. Hey, guy.
Do fireballs deal a set amount of damage, or does it increase?
No, it doesn't scale. It is what it is. All magic is like that.
So you won't get an increase until you get a better rod.
A better rod or another crystal. I'll show off all the magic. I don't mind doing that.
Well, the crystal is a different type of magic. That I would imagine that all the base level magic is comparable in strength. No?
No. Fireballs are the weakest spell in the game.
Okay. Now the Ragna Blade.
Oh god, when we get the Ragna Blade, everything's fucked. One hit kill, no.
Dragon Slave!
You get
That's the max fireball.
You don't know how correct you are. Wait, where the fuck am I?
You're
fine. Oh, okay, I know where I am. This leads to nowhere. This leads to a place where, like, half the battlements are gone. Alright. One more kill. By the way, when those clouds are in their electric state, they can't take any damage.
Oh, I just figured you couldn't sword attack them or you'd get hurt.
No, they just can't take damage. I'll try to show it off if they defeat. Yep.
Oh.
And there we go, level 10. Let's see if that's enough.
One level.
No, one level was the difference between life or death in that Samson battle.
Yeah. And part... I'm not going to say it was part of the reason we did the merger, but... Something good about us being able to stream from both of our computers is that we could put the save file back on your computer and you could grind off screen if you felt the need to.
Yeah, which was what I might
off
do.
Stream.
Off screen. Well, off screen is off stream.
Yeah.
Alright. What's this, my damage output gonna be like now? Slightly better!
We also found the ob setting that lets us keep recording even if the stream drops. So... If the stream does drop, it won't...
We won't tell.
We won't have a bunch of different files to put together on YouTube. I mean, I don't know if it'll, you know, tell us that the stream's dropped. But, you know, it's something. Found the weak spot.
Ah!
He didn't know how to react for a little bit there. He had to calculate his move carefully.
I forgot, he could go into desperation and then just run you down.
Yeah.
Like a dick.
Well, you're doing damage at least.
I'm doing damage before I
go
was
left
it.
Or right immediately to avoid the lunge.
Yeah, done. Oh, that was safe.
Yeah, if you find the sweet spot, it seems you're good. Until he does that.
Yeah, the fireballs are what deal the most damage. I just can't hit him.
Yeah.
Like I can't. Like his sword. This year's sword is so shitty. It's like a butter knife.
Yeah. You just like, made me imagine Kenpachi going around with a butter knife and still slaying
will
everything.
Will he be effective with it? Nasir,
yeah.
What the fuck are you doing?
A knife is my chosen weapon. Why?
Just an actual... God damn it.
It'd be nice if you got...
I'm good at this game. I'm... playing the entire, like, the fault on the boss.
It'd be nice if you got just, like, a little bit of XP for attempting the boss each time.
No, because then it wouldn't save. This game is an old-school save system. Dang it. Yeah, hitboxes. I don't need this right now. This map. I hope that's... Did it close on anything? Nope, it didn't.
Oh, yeah, you have your laptop to log out when you close it.
No, not when it's plugged in.
Oh.
That was your mistake that other time.
Yeah. I mean, I have my set to never, like, sleep or anything unless I put it to sleep manually.
Okay, listen, guy. I'm willing to work with you. Fuck! Guy, listen!
Alright, healing is disabled in fights too, right?
Yeah, you can't auto-heal and you can't cast magic.
Can you use healing items?
Yeah, you can. Do we have any? Would they even be worth it? Guess we're finding out. Alright, we got the pot of healing.
Don't use it unless you get a substantial amount of damage in before you need it. Because otherwise, in this case, it's just better to try again.
I might just need to grind some more, honestly.
Yeah.
God, I don't want to, because that's going to take time. 9. How many do you think? At 7 per kill.
980. That's 1250, or 250.
I would need to kill 250 enemies?
No, that's 30... 1, 2, 3, 4, 35 enemies.
Fuck it. Let's get it done. 35 enemies. So how's the things been going with in your life?
I Geico called me fat.
Oh, well.
McDonald's happens. Now I'm watching you play this.
Is this, you consider this a negative?
Eh.
So you do.
And we're debating about how to go through with the Pokemon stream in the future.
You don't want me breaking down like I did last time.
Well, and I also want you to be able to get through the game. You're kind of flailing to tread water at this point.
Well, thank you, Mr. Pokemon Master. Fuck it, I'll grab this.
Gold!
I got 100 of it. Like, I have all the items I need, plus, well, I guess not the sword I need.
But you didn't grind enough, you gotta go back and grind!
You're not experienced enough, you gotta kill some more monsters!
Don't you wanna have fun playing the game? Go fight these monsters more!
God, is South Park taking on the concept of a JRPG?
Grinding.
Oh,
this is the main point of the game, you go around fighting monsters, the same monsters, over and over again! Isn't that fun?!
Hey, look, this guy's a gargoyle, I think. You got fun fighting him. He'll fight a slime and then a cloud. Because you're high up in the air, I guess. You want to beat the chimera? Well, fuck you.
Sat, you want to see new enemies? No, you got to beat the old ones. 500 times!
You know, this would be a bit better if the combat system was better.
Yeah.
Like, you know, more fluid. You're not swinging a fucking toothpick at your enemies.
Yeah. You keep playing.
Alright. What are you doing?
I'm gonna pull something up while you're playing.
Okay. What have I got on my tabs?
Ow.
Alright.
He's not gonna can't be reached.
What?
YouTube server DNS address could not be found. Oh, never mind. Why YouTube?
Why YouTube? Where's the fair use? What's it recommending me?
Saturday morning Scrub Lords.
Yeah, that
Sonic
makes sense.
Freedom Fighters 2. TNG Picard owns the Shellyak.
Oh, that's a next generation thing.
Akinator thinks I'm a fat furry.
Who?
From Pixel Cat Gamer.
Oh, Pixel Cat. Yeah, I know him.
And Dong Dong Never Die.
Saturday Morning Scrub Lords.
What happened to Great Disney Villains? Asks Channel Awesome.
Yeah, what happened to them? It was Jafar and then fucking Frollo and then. That was it! They just disappeared!
This has a picture of Cruella de Vil and Captain Hook.
Were they awesome?
Yeah,
okay. Cruella de Vil was just a person who wanted to wear nice clothing, I guess.
Yeah.
What are you looking up? If you need to, like, turn off the music on this, you totally can.
No, I'm not gonna play sound. I just,
I can't believe, I think this game expects you to grind a lot. Oh, is that 3D dot heroes?
Yeah.
Oh, that looks better than Lagoon, honestly.
See that fucking sword?
Oh, wait, let me see the sword. Oh my god!
That's the sword you get, and it only gets bigger throughout the game.
Fuck!
It takes the whole screen length at the end.
That's so cool! Why can't we have that? Okay, Lagoon. That was a better fucking sword.
Now the whole that 3D dot Game Heroes game is just
basically a modernized Zelda 1. So if you like the Zelda 1 gameplay,
I'd be willing to give it a try.
Yeah.
Probably play it blind. We don't play enough games blind anymore.
Yeah.
We know too many.
I mean, if it was a blind play, I think it'd have to be something that,
like Sonic 06, but then again,
something that was either short, or something that we weren't immediately going to commit to. Like, we'd have to give it a chance to see if we wanted to keep going or not.
Is this worth our time stream?
Yeah. Like, we play a variety of games.
Yeah. I just keep matching because I want them to die quicker.
How far along are you?
1151. I'm under 100 there. Yeah. I just need to...
So, 80 more.
Grinding is...
That's 12 enemies.
It's not like grinding in Pokemon, like with permadeaths enabled, where one wrong move could spell your doom.
Yeah.
This is just like, I just gotta kill these fuckers, and some of them are gonna be more annoying than others.
Decide if we're still having permadeath or not yet. I offered you an out because I do want you to see the end of the game.
Well, I just lose all my Pokemon, then I just have to watch you finish the game.
You realize all you have left is a Magikarp? How to get a game over in Pokemon Red Blue. Those videos exist.
Oh, really?
People come up with ways to fuck your save file so there's no recovery. And most of them involve like catching a Magikarp and releasing all your Pokemon.
God, you can't release any Pokemon with no Pokemon left, right?
No, but if you have just a Magikarp left, you can't level it up.
Like, what does Oak say? Like, you can't quit, Ash!
No, like, you're stuck. You only have Splash. You have no way to get EXP or catch new Pokemon again. Well, no, I guess...
You can
just throw a Pokeball.
You have to be out of money.
Yeah, you'd have to totally exhaust your money. And another thing they do is, go to an island like Cinnabar... and get rid of all your Pokemon that know Surf.
Oh no, that's mean! Except for Magikarp.
Yeah.
But then you still have the HM Surf.
If you can't catch any Pokemon that can learn it, because you don't have any money to buy Pokeballs.
Well, you can use the Old Rod and grab a Pokemon that knows Surf.
But you don't have any Pokeballs, and you don't have any money to buy Pokeballs.
Okay, there you go. That's how you lose at Pokemon.
Yeah. By trying to lose.
Three more. Somebody did that with GoldenEye and stuff. Because GoldenEye was like the first FPS to use like mission objectives and stuff.
Yeah.
You could actually fail mission objectives and still continue on the level and like get to the end, but it wouldn't count. So some people are like, alright, let's fail all the mission objectives and get to the end. So
yeah.
You have people just shooting innocent scientists and then destroying mission equipment and stuff. God, Everything exploded in GoldenEye. All right, level 11.
I never played GoldenEye. I've heard very positive things about it. Never played.
If it's your first FPS, I'm sure it'd be fine. It doesn't have a modern FPS aesthetic because it uses like.
Yeah, I didn't play FPSs in the early days, so I didn't. I was not part of the Doom or GoldenEye communities or Perfect Dark. I played Jet Set Gemini. Was that it?
Jet Set... Oh.
Something Gemini.
Jet Force Gemini?
Jet Force Gemini.
That was the one where you shoot bugs.
I played that...
I've never played that.
I played it multiplayer at a friend's house a lot. And I remember that being a lot of fun, the multiplayer. But that was also me as a kid. And,
Let's do it.
Tried playing...
Oh my god! I'm able to take much more of a hit. Oh, nope.
I tried playing the single player more recently and couldn't do anything with it. I couldn't maintain interest.
I could probably play it single player and maintain interest. I've never played that game, so it'd be fun just to check it out.
Yeah.
Alright, so I didn't get any hits that time. Yeah, that's much better!
I don't think they have totally custom skins in the console versions of Minecraft, but they release like dozens and dozens of skin packs, and one of them actually includes a Jet Force Gemini character.
Oh, that's cool.
So that's
That's because that franchise was made by Rare, which is now owned by Microsoft.
Okay, it must have been like a Rare Games set of skins. I was just surprised that was included as an official like DLC for anything. People remember that game.
Yeah. Come on, you motherfucker. Let's go.
I wonder if there's a pattern. Does he do 3 fireballs and then lunge?
I don't know. His patterns are very weird. Are you not in desperation mode, you fuck?
Well, he can only lunge straight forward. So he's only going to do it if you're in front of him.
I don't know this guy's name, by the way.
No?
Yeah. For all I know, he could be called Cerberus Mark II.
But he only has 2 hands. Wouldn't he be like the Cerberus Beta? 3 fireballs and lunge.
Oh, now he's in desperation. He's going to keep doing that. So, the trick... Fuck! I messed it up! Wait. Come on. Come on. No! Did I do it? I did it!
Found the sweet spot.
I found it! Speedrunners use this.
You gotta keep jumping to make this work.
Yeah, I gotta. There we go! I got him! Fuck, that was harder than it needed to be, but I got him.
You defeated Nutella.
Nutella!
Nutella?
Nutella!
Delicious on toast!
I got a silver sword!
Great!
Yeah, I guess he was lodged in his, like, cranium or something.
Yeah.
Alright, we'll equip it. Fuck!
It was just stuck in his shoulder since the last hero that came to try to fight this guy.
Look at my attack now, it's higher than my defense.
What was it before?
It was like, here. 63. 93.
A pleasant increase?
That is... Yeah, that's
is it
good.
Longer than your previous sword?
I don't know, let me check.
Nope!
Nope! Still the same size! Still got the kitty version. Okay, now we go down to the bottom floor, and then head on to Dwarf Desert.
Dwarf Desert?
Yes, that's the next area we're going. By beating this guy, we unlock the way to the desert.
To the Gerudos.
If the Gerudos...
Gonna go meet the Dwarf!
God.
In Dwarf Desert!
Ganondorf is just a literal dwarf with like a long white beard.
Oh, you're saying dwarf.
Yeah, not dwarf, not the other dwarf. Dwarf. Alright, well. I should probably save. Yeah, I don't want to fight that guy again.
Man, the Phillips mascot really beefed up.
Phillips CDI's mascot, a double-headed lion. God, with a mascot like that, why did they fail?
They had twice the, they had twice the mascot of MGM.
Nintendo could have partnered with Sony, but they instead decided, fuck it.
Was that Nintendo's decision, or was it Sony saying, yeah, we can go solo, fuck that.
Here's what happened. So, if I remember, I'm pretty sure how it went was,
Do you know where you're going? You need the map again.
That's fine. I can just go down here and then I go up. This area is much more easy to navigate than fucking.
You gotta go through
the basement.
Yeah, I guess you're right. So the story was with Sony.
So they were initially Nintendo was initially gonna partner up with Sony to create like a disc drive system.
The Nintendo PlayStation.
Yeah, or like some kind of add-on for that, right? Yeah. And then.
I think it was a new system.
But the kicker was that Nintendo was on the verge of making a bad deal because they hadn't read the fine print thing saying that Sony would get all their like first party licenses.
Yeah.
So instead they decided to go behind their back and just say, hey, Philips,
What do you know about disk-based systems? And they're like, as anyone knows, I guess. And then the rest is history.
Yeah.
And then
preferably forgotten history.
And then, as a result, Sony, like, signed up all the hot RPG Japanese-based talent that was on, that was made works for N64.
Yeah.
Or SNES. And that's why there's not really very many RPG games on Nintendo.
Yeah.
Because Squaresoft made them all. Square and Enix.
You mean on N64?
On, yeah. There's Quest 64 and that's it.
Yeah. The Final Fantasy games made their way back to the Nintendo systems eventually.
Yeah. After that heat died down.
Yeah.
After they were able to kind of just let those painful memories run their course.
But.
Alright, maps up.
No, I was thinking if Square was involved in Paper Mario. They were Mario RPG. And then
They are...
Someone else did
Intelligent
Mario.
Design.
But they did a good job. That was a good RPG.
That was
64.
Good. The first two Paper Mario games. They also didn't play like an RPG would play because of their...
Not a Square RPG, no.
No, Square RPGs are just... you gotta wait for your turn in real time, and then you... You combine like attacks and magic, and you figure out how each boss plays.
They're not as inventive. They're more about the storytelling.
Yeah, and then meanwhile, you get Super Mario 64 RPG, Paper Mario.
You know where you're going?
Yeah, I need to go down. No, it's down here.
I asked because it looked like you were going in circles again while you're talking.
What? This can't be. Is this?
This
it?
Can't be impossible.
This is what I'm thinking. Oh, okay. I'm fucking up.
Shifting.
God, every time you get to a floor, it randomly shuffles. This
Mom,
year die.
Close the door. Android Ace, what are you doing?
It's like the fucking hypercube
muscle tower. That was remember General White was trying to have the moving wall in the maze,
and that didn't work. Cause Goku is Goku. Here we are. Okay, we're almost out. We'll never have to come back here ever again. In this particular part of the castle.
Gee, I wonder what Dark Soul is up to. Or Dark Spirit, right?
I just wonder what the Dark Spirit is up to. Okay, let's move on.
So we're just gonna cut any just music without us talking in this game and replace it with Seinfeld, right?
God!
Teleport!
Alright. It worked! I guess!
Okay, that's one way to get around a castle.
Yeah, so...
Oh yeah, more slap bass!
All the slap bass. So welcome to Dwarf Desert. This is the first really dickish part of the game.
Oh, the first.
By this game standard. So you got two enemies. You got those things. They deal a lot of damage and they're...
Burn the wolf.
Welcome to a world where fireball has become useless. But as a result, I believe 566.
Shall we dance?
575.
Okay, so that's 9 EXP.
9 EXP. Or what?
Yeah, you were right.
Okay.
So the amount of EXP you need for a new level increases, but the amount you get from enemies also increases.
Yeah, let me bring up the map here. I'll bring up this one's map so I know where I'm going.
It's not scaling EXP. Like, you get less from lower enemies.
No, you get the same amount. It's just that there will be ones that are... Oh, that's Dwarf Cave. Where's the desert? Oh, here we go. See, I made everything. Okay, Dwarf Desert is quite possibly the most straightforward of we've had so far.
And you still need a map for it.
Yes. So G leads to Dwarf. Oh, we need to go left. Okay, so here's the second enemy.
Left. Oh, it's a rock.
Yes.
It's electric. It's Alolan Geodude.
Oh god dang.
The fucking eyebrows on that, right?
Oh yeah, I did. I also saw it's got ore, apparently, so I guess that explains why it's able to have
powers.
Electric power. That psychic writes you, though.
Yeah, I didn't know it was psychic. I also didn't know that apparently the palm tree executor was dragon.
It's a dragon.
It's grass dragon.
Dragon trees!
You think it bears dragon fruit?
I'm pretty sure that's the joke. By the way, dragon fruit's delicious. So this is a dwarf cave. We need to get here. But it's blocked by rocks. Now think about what we need to break rocks.
Obviously we need a Machoke that knows strength.
That's how you get the Mew. But what do you think? We're going to the dwarf village and we're gonna get an item.
We're gonna need to get free all the carpenters and get them to saw the rocks open. I don't know.
We need to
bomb Dodongos!
We need to get the bracelet to lift the bomb plants to get access into it.
Oh, that was my next guess.
We
need to get the silver gauntlet so we can lift the rocks over our heads.
Okay. You see, all those things we were saying, they make kind of sense.
Yeah.
No. How you're supposed to actually do it?
We need to water the rock with a watering can so it'll panic and then we can catch it. Right?
God, what was that from?
Pseudo-Wudu.
Oh yeah. The tree.
Rock tree.
The Pokemon. Tree that the rock that pretended to be a tree.
Yeah.
Forgot about that.
That's why we gotta play Gen 2.
Woo! Like those two fucking scientists in the anime that are like arguing over whether or not it's like a tree or a rock.
Yeah.
But
was that a thing? You got eaten by wolves.
Good thing I saved. Where did I save? I don't know where I am. Oh, is it the peninsula?
You saved smack in the middle of the desert, which doesn't help you at all on the map.
I'm gonna save near the enemy too. I need to actually start probably killing these guys at some point.
Yeah, I wonder how much EXP they give you. Because the wolves give you 9.
Okay, 9, yeah. I'll have to check. So we're at 1604 right now. God, I need to get to the village because the healing is much faster there.
Yeah.
Ah! Wolf! Nice doggy. Good doggy.
Snake, you've been noticed!
No, don't cuddle!
Wow, they are really fire immune.
Okay. Alright, so now we're at 1613. Come on! See, it locks onto you.
Just rapid fire.
It kind of backed off a little bit. Wait,
what? Here's one. Check your EXP. 1622.
I don't know. If I die here, I want to try it again. 1622. Ah! By the way, you know what we should start watching?
What?
I'm gonna pull the trigger on this. We should start watching Next Generation.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, not only because of John Delancey, but just because...
Check your EXP.
Okay.
10 EXP.
10! Okay, so these things are...
One more than the wolves.
They're actually also slightly easier to kill.
Yeah.
So once you're jumping, you gotta commit to wherever you're jumping to.
Yeah. Does not have the aerial control of Mario.
No. Well, I take that back. You can move back and forth in the air as much as you want. You just can't go at 90 degree rotate. Where the fuck am I? Are you fucking serious? Did I get lost?
At least we got a sick slap base.
Yeah, nothing sicker than this slap base, yo. Okay, I think this might be where I need to go. Please? I just want to... What?
You know you need to go up, right? So just keep going up.
Yeah, I'm going up. Ah! Nope. He's faster than me.
Oh, there's the wall.
Is this the wall?
So you gotta go to the one to the right. You're in the far top left right now, right?
I think so, yeah. So I need to go to the right one. No, please just leave me alone.
Bang.
It's good at keeping things away, at least. That's good. Okay, this might be it. Yeah, no, this is totally... I totally missed. Alright, welcome to this one.
Nazir deals with the wolf den in a far different way from Snake.
Dinagul. Running and firing fireballs. So, Welcome to the Dwarf Village.
Yep, looks like shit.
Hey! The Dwarf Cave is the east is a horrible cave.
Please,
women and children should never go near it.
Little person.
Little person cave, midget cave.
Have you ever seen the Moonstone?
No.
It evolves Clefairy.
Oh, really? Even if just once, I want to see it before I die. Okay, so keep that in mind. That's how we get to the next area.
Okay. We gotta show him the moon's tear.
When I was walking in the desert the other day, I found a gorgeous lady, but she looked a little scary.
It's a Yuki Onna, but in the desert.
Yuki Onna in the desert?
It was gnome.
Why is this desert so cold? We dwarves are masters of making weapons.
The elders are sword specialists. So I just got a new sword.
Maybe we can get a new sword here. Where's your weapon shop?
Go away!
Oh, I'm so busy! Alright, guy, bye. Hey, kid! If you came all the way to this village, you should go to the armor shop.
You can find weapons there.
You find something unique to this village. Alright. I'll find it. Eventually. The towns are designed like mazes.
I guess. Not really mazes, just randomly.
There's no map, no, like, weapon shop, arrow.
Sign, anything.
This is music. This is two tones!
Every building looks identical.
Yeah, stop telling me about your masturbation fetish. Oh, it's you! You're a sight for sore eyes, what's up?
I rode here on Holy Thunder.
No, it's not here. Where did I lose it?
Your hammer?
We need to do something else first. So you are Nasir, the champion of the light. As one of the village elders, I have something to tell you.
Okay.
I am your father. It's about the Moonblade. You will need the sword in the near future.
To seal Ganon?
Yeah, I guess. To seal the Moonblade is made of a legendary stone called Moonstone.
Okay.
Clefairy Blade.
So that's why they're so rare.
Yeah.
These assholes are making swords out of them.
Here's the ancient book about the Moonblade. Please take it.
Dot, dot, dot.
Ancient book. It's useless. It doesn't do much. It is said that the Moonstone seems to be in the Dwarf Cave. The entrance is blocked by rocks. If you can get in, use this book!
So how do I get in? Not my problem. I was about to ask, when do you get a new magic item?
Yeah, the Sky Book.
Yeah.
You can get in, use this book, hands you a staff. Alright, we can't get in there yet, but
no,
we will.
No, you can't use your bigger fireballs.
Yeah, we can. Hold on, I'll show them off. Three-way fireball!
Oh, so we finally get what the enemies have had for two dungeons.
Kind of. Nasir, I'm in trouble because I lost my pendant somewhere.
He always looks so uptight and or bored.
Yeah.
He looks like Mendo's face, but with blonde hair.
Yeah, but he's apparently your friend? Can you look for it, please? Yeah! Really? I had it when I was in Volo, so I may have lost it around there!
Welcome to Volo, Outfitters.
Volo is the elf village we were just at!
Yeah.
We gotta go backtrack!
Through the desert.
Back through the desert.
This game sure likes backtracking.
By the way, there's no weapons village in here.
You mean no weapons shop?
No weapons shop, no armor shop.
That's accessible or just none at all?
I was looking and I wasn't able to find anything. Come on. Your masters are making weapons. Jim, I can't, like, sample them or anything.
You not, like, check the doors or anything?
No, the doors, you're supposed to, you can walk right into them, and that should be enough. Yeah, this town's unfriendly.
Do you have a map of the town?
Why would somebody bother me getting a map for a town?
Maybe it'll tell you which building the shop is.
Nope, not there.
Oh, well.
Oh, there's a map for the gold cave we could have used. I had to use fucking maps when I first played this game, too.
Yeah.
Alright. We're fully healed. We're going back out on a journey. Ah!
With wolves. Almost died immediately.
There we go. So that's a 8-8. That's 8. And in all honesty, the initial part is the strongest.
Yeah.
When I say the strongest, I mean it's the only part that deals damage.
Oh, so the three ones don't?
No. As far as I already know. Oh, whoops. God. So, what do you think? Is this the worst music you've heard so far?
No.
Oh.
I don't think it's bad music, it's just there. Very heavy on the slap bass.
What the? Oh, it's this one. Come on. No, it's not that one. Wait, where the fuck am I? If that's not that, then
oh,
what is what?
Stone down there.
Oh, that's it. That's where I need to go.
The catchphrase of this stream, where the fuck am I?
Man, the cartographer's union should be pissed.
You think that's a popular career in the Slayers verse cartographer?
Popular? No. High paying? Yes.
There's got to be a lot of wilds that are occupied by monsters.
Yeah, that's why it's scope out. This is dangerous work. So the first time I picked up this game, it was in the middle of a save at like that cave, dwarf cave.
Yeah.
And I tried playing and I immediately died. So I'm like, okay, maybe I'm missing something.
You aren't. You just needed to grind more.
Yeah, so I started from the very beginning. I got to that point.
And you died in the same way?
Well, I had to get used to how strong these enemies were.
Yeah.
Yeah. Alright, so, somewhere in Volo. Where do you think that means?
Presumably in the town. But no.
Yeah, that's exactly what it means. But it's not like you gotta find it randomly.
You just have to enter the town, and someone says, "Here, have this." Good job.
Yeah, someone will say that. Yeah, here we go. I found a pennant at the village border. Is this yours? Yes.
No.
But it's mine now.
It is now, nerd!
Be careful not to drop it again. Well, that is that side quest. Let's go back to the castle! God, these heroes must get fit from all this walking. I'm power walking! Oh, what are you doing?
Something else I want to look up. We're playing on my computer, so I gotta use your computer.
Alright.
Otherwise, I can look stuff up while you're playing it.
Fair enough. Alright! Backtrack. So, apparently this lagoon, at a certain point, has a desert.
Yeah?
Like, around it. I presume that it's just taking place all around this, like, giant lake. Yeah, of course you're going there.
I don't know who that is, but I don't think it's the same guy.
Wait, what'd you look up?
Nasir.
Nasir?
Assassin's Creed.
Oh! That's not the Nasir you're thinking of!
Agron Nasir Spartacus.
Who?
I don't know. Is there a Nasir in 300?
You're seriously trying to look up Lagoon porn?
Just wanted to see if it exists.
You could have just typed in Lagoon.
I could have. I thought Nazir was a little more unique, though. There are more likely to be more lagoons than Nazirs. I was wrong!
There's only one other lagoon, and it's a black lagoon.
Yeah.
Ah! Stupid fucking...
Doesn't work.
Oh, just fire immune those rocks.
Because it's a rock. Ember doesn't work against rocks.
Hey, that's the first type advantage that lines up with Pokemon instead of totally contradicting it.
You're so obsessed with that. That's great.
Just making commentary.
Is that where I'm looking? No, that's not the right... Is it? The features are just vague enough. No, that's the right one.
Lagoon number two. Jack is lost.
Well, I mean... Everything looks the same.
I'm not saying you're wrong.
I would like to have a Gallant Hedgehog suntanning as a marker of, oh, this is where I should be.
This game needs landmarks.
Something! Hey, Thor, I found your fucking pendant! Like, that's my main memories of this game. Man, it's hard to kill things in this game, and... I'm fucking lost.
Yeah.
Nothing was obvious.
Thor, God of Thunder. There you are.
I'm relieved. You really helped me out. Thank you. I made the promise on my honor. I'll give you this powerful mirror.
On my honor as a Quincy.
I'll give you this powerful mirror. Powerful mirror.
Good item name.
You are looking at how to get into the fucking dwarf cave. You use the powerful mirror to break the rocks. This mirror has the power to smash big rocks into pieces.
That makes sense.
It will help you. I must go now. I have a feeling that I'll see you again. So long.
Probably with another item lost.
And he's gone. Thor. I guess Thor's supposed to be our, like, childhood friend or something? No, because he doesn't know who we are.
Yeah. Alright,
dwarf cave. Okay, I'm gonna say dwarf cave is easier to navigate than Phillip's castle.
So what do you think? We get to the boss door and then call it so you can do the necessary grinding?
Oh, fuck no. There's... We're gonna have to go to Dwarf Cave twice.
Yeah? So we have to do something there and then come back?
We have to do something there, we have to get something from there, go back, and then gain access to the boss door.
Oh.
Are you noticing a pattern yet, Xelrog?
Are we gonna be able to do that in 30 minutes?
We could get as far as we can in 30 minutes. Keep in mind, we can save anywhere.
Yeah.
And I'm less concerned about things lining up than you are. Alright, I think
it's that's... just a matter of otherwise.
Oh, that's the tip beat. Otherwise...
Where you stop to be able to, grind off screen if necessary. But I guess you could do that at any point.
Yeah. It's not like it's gonna be, Besides, grinding a dwarf cave is one of the easiest places to grind it.
Yeah.
Places to grind it because of the. Okay, seriously, where the fuck am I? What? What even is this stretch of land?
I don't see this on the map.
This map is lying to me. Oh, we're not leaving. We're just going to the top right. Never mind.
If only you could jump over the mountains.
That'd be cool. This supposed to be mountains or just really large rocks?
I don't know.
Inconveniently placed rocks.
Large rocks, small mountains, what's the difference?
Sounds like a fucking desert and more like a canyon. Dwarf canyon.
Yeah.
Makes more sense because dwarfs are known to like live in mountains rather than just fucking desert.
Yeah.
I don't like the desert.
And caves, which are usually in mountains.
Wait. Do we make it?
Are we here?
Yeah, we're here.
Okay.
Equip the mirror.
The mirror.
Smash the rocks with it. Just smash it against them.
Powerful mirror.
The mirror never breaks. That's the secret.
What's the... There we go.
That's a cool effect, I guess. The rock just vanishes.
Vanishes into thin air.
It gets sent to another dimension.
It's powerful in that
inside the mirror.
Inside the mirror is a black hole.
Mirror of the next dimension.
Welcome to Dwarf Cave. So the first part of Dwarf Cave is literally just a jump, like jumping.
Yeah.
It's platforming.
I'm sure it's fun to go back again, back the other way on too. Barely made that one.
I think there's a way you can actually just avoid this coming up.
Yeah.
Maybe another door. It's only used for that one point. You like this music?
It's okay. I don't think the music in this game has been bad, just, you know,
just
nothing stand
weird.
Out.
Kind of weird. Their heavy reliance on the slap bass.
Notable.
Ah!
So I slipped. When's the last time you saved?
Beginning of the cave.
Okay.
Yeah. Instant death. Permadeath pits.
Hardcore mode. If you die once in this game, you have to start the whole save file over.
Oh, shit!
Look before you
leave!
Doesn't
matter what genre it is. If it's platforming, I suck at it. Can you hand me a pillow? So I can keep my neck straight. Thank you. I'm curling up. That's how I get my power. So when I get to the very end, I'll save again. And then there's another... As you saw, there's another part of it. And then that's where we'll get to the... That's where we'll get to the bottom part.
Oh.
So, falling down a pit in this game, instant death.
Yeah.
Just wanted to keep that in mind.
Okay. I'm gonna guess the boss has death chain, death pits.
That's not what I'm leading at.
Oh, because that would suck.
That would suck. I don't think any boss battle uses instant death pits, honestly. Which, you know, that would have cemented this game's status as the worst game in the world if they tried that shit.
The boss doesn't even damage you, it just tries to knock you into the pit.
I'm a pacifist!
That was one of the Yoshi's Island bosses did that.
Yeah, that was the one where it's like, it doesn't have a weak spot.
It was the, I guess two of them did that. There was the slug, and there was also a ghost jar.
Yeah. Wasn't there the one where it's like they shrunk you and it was eaten by something else?
Frog.
God. Poor fetish. Alright. See this lava?
Yeah.
What do you think happens when you jump in it?
Either instant death or there's an invisible wall or you start taking slow damage.
Oh shit. Yeah.
Slow damage.
Slow damage.
You got good boots.
Great boots. I got great armor. It's immune to fire. Oh god damn it! So those things kind of just fire whenever they want to. I'll try not to kill any of them, because these things are...
Game over.
Yeah, well, that's because I fucked off and, like...
God, what is that sound effect?
The organ?
No, those guys firing.
Don't.
It's such a Mario sound effect, I just can't remember what enemy uses it.
There we go. So those things are worth, like, a lot of EXP.
If you get them before they disappear.
Yeah. But they deal a lot of damage.
Clearly. You wanna save?
See?
Told
instant
you.
Death!
I warned you.
Well, if I saved there, I would've just died repeatedly and I would've had to start all over.
Oh, like the whole save file?
Yeah. So, as you probably guessed, all these enemies are immune
check
to fire.
Your EXP.
I think, yeah.
1738.
He's gone. 1738. Yeah, okay, I gotta stop fucking around with this.
You can't jump over them, because they're not projectiles.
They're not projectiles, they're enemies. And I want to kill them, because they're the best...
1738. 1770, so 22 EXP.
Yes, they're that best source we're gonna get in this cave, so. If I can stop
Stop doing
I
that!
I died!
Early save after you get the XP.
I mean, going into a active volcano wasn't gonna be easy.
But we gotta find Salamander.
This year just bumps into Luca. Hey, why are you here? Oh, I'm looking for the Moonstone. You? I'm trying to find Salamander.
Well, okay. Good luck, bro.
Hey, don't you find it weird how we're not like suffocating to death? Nah, it's magic.
So you can walk through lava and not be hurt? Well, I can fuck lava and not be hurt.
Okay, I forgot. I'm gonna need to fuck- OH SHIT!
You're traveling with a Tsundere snake lady? That's rough, buddy.
Oh. Oh my god, there's so much shit!
You can pause. 1802.
Yeah, I can actually level up in this dungeon really easily.
Which you'll probably need to for the boss, judging by the previous two.
The next boss is less hard than, in theory, the next boss should be not as hard.
Yeah.
Okay. So, let's see, what's here?
Easier than Nutella.
Nutella. Okay, I know where I need to go. I assume that'll be good arsenal, like, a good... Magic sword!
You're getting dive bombed from the right.
Yeah, I see him. Bye!
Does the magic sword deal damage to enemies who are, like, resistant to physical?
It deals damage to enemies, yes.
Just a stronger sword?
It's a stronger sword! Look at how strong that sword is!
That's good. Solid increase. We don't have the one true ring yet. Still hunting for that. We're looking in the right place.
Yeah, we are.
Volcano.
Section 2. So what does 2 go to? Oh, 2 goes to... I'll figure it out. First, I just want to see.
Oh, that other jumping area looks like a bitch.
This one?
Yeah.
That was the one I was at. That was the second part. I'm already done with it. Okay, jump up here.
You just say fuck it to navigating the lava, just jump over it.
Yeah. It's not that... Ah! It's not gonna be that much anyway, so... The other chest here is just gold, so... Some guy who's able to get the world record, like, speedrun on this got it deathless and saveless. Yeah. I have no idea how he managed to accomplish that.
Well, I mean, saving takes time, so of course.
Yeah. My god!
Just a punching bag between two lava bubbles. Do these enemies have official names, you think, in, like, the manual that came with the game?
This game had a manual? Damn
you
it!
You jumped quickly enough that you didn't even take the lava damage.
Yeah. I'll just go right now.
I guess if you're frame perfect, you can avoid that. Yep.
This sounds like...
Honestly, the slap bass is more fitting in a volcano. I don't know why.
Well, because... I don't know.
I'm used to hearing it. Maybe it's the Spyro 2 soundtrack. Because the volcano level uses a slap bass.
Oh, it does?
Yeah.
That's great irony. Okay, we can actually... If I go left and up here, I can find something that'll allow me to survive easier.
Then again, everything in Spyro used a slap bass, didn't it?
Oh my god!
You can, You
got another last save. Oh fuck!
You got like three of these guys who will shoot down here. You can get EXP off them, right? On the bottom wall.
Yeah, I need to get a certain thing that allow me to actually take these guys out without having to get in close for a sword swipe. Fuck!
A butter knife swipe.
Mommy, I'm gonna go to the volcano and play now. That's nice. Be careful not to lose your butter knife, honey.
You think there's some secret?
Here we go.
Wind crystal. You think there's some secret lore in the, like, Pokeverse? Some dark secret that we don't know about? Why 10-year-olds are trusted to go adventuring at these wild things? Like, maybe they're constructed life forms whose, like, prime directive is to never harm humans.
Pokemon?
Yeah, so that's why it's okay for 10-year-olds to go on adventures.
But that's not true, because you see all those bee drills at fucking the first episode of...
But did they ever really kill anyone?
Besides, Oak was like, it's dangerous to fucking go out without a Pokemon escort.
But have we ever seen a Pokemon hurt a human?
Fuck, you got me there.
Those Spearows beat up Pikachu. Wind Cutter! What's the level 1 one?
This is the level 1 one.
Oh.
So,
So you have the first staff...
Ah!
You have the first staff equipped?
Yeah. Oh, god damn it.
Good noise.
So,
So now you can blow fires out.
Yes. With wind! Airbending. So we did have firebending, now we got airbending.
I hear that's effective against the Fire Nation.
Ah. Okay, so we're here. Now we gotta hit point D. What's a point E? Oh, I'm gonna need that! So this game is kind of buggy.
Yeah?
As you FUCK!
When do you save?
Very beginning of the section. Oh no, I didn't. Good. And I still got... Alright, let's see what the next one is. Phase 2 magic. Ah! That's what I get for trying to, that one. Wind Blaster!
So, shotgun version?
We'll see in a second. I just wanna...
Sniped.
They're a good source of EXP, but they just love to do that shit. That's... Okay, I'm gonna need to do something different.
Yeah.
Probably stop in front of it.
You're gonna have to walk through that last bit of lava.
No!
Well, that worked out. Protective ring.
So, this game has rings. Rings allow major boosts in, like, stats.
Yeah.
Only downside is that it drains MP. But...
Constantly?
Yes. But, here's the thing. When you're fully drained of MP, as long as you don't, like, check the menu again... Then it's still equipped, even though your MP is drained and it has to slowly go back up.
Okay.
So, as a result, you can get a major boost in defense and just have it stick there, and it'll still stay there as long as you don't check the menu or you don't level up.
Okay. So it's supposed to be like a temporary use item. You better save.
Yeah, like a desperation item.
Like you only use it for a brief period of a fight, the 11-second battle.
Yeah, but you can just have it forever.
Tuckinator is in chat and says this looks cool. Thank you, this is our favorite RPG Maker game.
It looks better than it actually is, honestly. But if you want to play it, go right ahead. It's a very challenging game.
I'm kidding, this is an actual Super NES game, not RPG Maker.
Yeah, so, number...
You're not killing those guys? Even the weak wind magic one.
Sorry, I was taking a look at the...
Oh, save.
See? Oh, damn it! Did I save when I got the ring?
I did, you, yes. Yeah.
Yeah, see? So,
Might want to refill energy.
Yep, gotta recharge.
Thankfully you can do that in a volcano, not suffocate to death.
Yeah! Sulfur, what? Nah, I need to get to a certain point so that I can get the guy's precious fucking moonstone.
Sweet lava effect, by the way, just like that hypnotic layered tile gif.
It actually looks pretty cool.
Like, if you look at that focus on the lava, it looks like the background of, like, a drug trip in a cartoon.
Ah!
The song is catchy but repetitive.
Yes.
That's pretty much been my analysis of the music so far.
Welcome to Lagoon Sound OST.
Very repetitive, lots of slap bass. Silence Cave, and it's got the best music so far.
Yeah.
Save.
Yeah. Okay, I gotta re-equip the ring now.
Oh, it just because you went to the menu.
Yeah, that's fine.
Huzzah!
We got the moonstone! It looks like the frozen flame!
Yeah. We got blue fire.
What's he saying?
Now we gotta go. He doesn't say anything new. Now we gotta go unfreeze the Zora King.
Oi. Oi. Oi.
Oi.
Ah! You just stood there.
I did, yes. Not my finest moment. Fortunately. I just want to crib this music for something else. I'm not gonna fuck with the rings right now. I'll wait till the boss.
You re-equipped the ring, didn't you? Or does it every time you die you have to go back in?
Well, I died then, so I gotta.
So yeah, every time you die.
MP's draining. If you don't know where they spawn, then it can be hard. Oh.
So are those Doula hands? They look like headless knights.
Yeah, that's what I thought too, but they're just golems.
Or, yeah, lava golems. They thought of that too! Just forget the ring. You're better off just having access to a wind magic.
Yeah.
And get the moonstone.
Oh yeah, that's right.
And saving regularly.
Like,
extra defense isn't gonna help you against those guys. Saving often will.
Not unless I save right in front of it. That could kill my game.
Yeah, don't do that.
It's easier to navigate, but harder to survive.
It's like they added an actual challenge for this dungeon. God, that is really shitty, though, that you can fuck your save file by saving in the wrong place.
Yeah. What? But they appeared before, right? Yeah.
What's your EXP like now? 13. So level 13, that's good.
Yeah.
2010.
Okay, I forgot to show off the other magic. Let's do that. Wind Blaster! Alright, let's find somebody to,
Someone finally showed up just as we're near stopping. That always seems to happen. I feel like we wouldn't get a large number of. Oh,
dang
God.
It! If I try to cross the lava pits, then I just.
They spawn on top of you.
Yeah, let's try something new.
I feel like we won't get a large number of viewers unless we stream for like 8 hours at a time.
Yeah. I bet we could do that one of these days. Just. Oh, that's what that does!
So it's short range.
It's a break.
Doesn't seem as good.
Oh, that's good. You know why?
Why? Good.
Well, I would have been able to show it if.
I think you're better off right now with the projectile.
Yeah. Oh, dang it. Alright, let's try this again.
Introducing Seinfeld, the RPG.
Come on, Jerry, I can go on the adventure, you gotta trust me!
Okay, so, I mean, that they do have the dynamic of a traditional RPG party.
What's the deal with experience anyway?
That guy just went right through me!
Why do I need a number to tell me how I've experienced life?
God, okay, so Jerry Seinfeld's totally a bard, right?
Yeah, sure.
And then,
He's a jester.
Yeah, and then his, Kramer is like, I guess, the rogue?
He's like a handyman, right? Isn't he? Or he's like the
Eddie. He's the one with the schemes.
Yeah, he's Eddie. So yeah, rogue.
And then,
Or, merchant, if that were a class, maybe?
Yeah. And then,
George. What's the lady's name?
Elaine. The socialite.
When did you save?
Stop!
Just every two steps, save!
You know what this guide is saying? It's saying, save very often as it will be tough until you get the wind crystal. But I have the wind crystal.
It's still tough. Well, that worked. That
worked. Somehow survived that.
You found a winning strategy to get this far.
Okay.
Now for the next
okay,
area.
Whoa! Nope.
Elaine is basically the straight one. She's the D, right?
Yeah, except that like D, Elaine, good thing I saved.
Is less of a bitch than D?
Well, yeah.
Becomes.
Well, becomes more. She's always concerned with like dating like the perfect guy, and she never has like the same guy twice, which is not totally bad, but she always ends up breaking up with her boyfriends for like really crappy reasons.
I guess she'd be the mage just for lack of one.
Yeah.
And then George.
George Costanza, the paladin.
Paladin?
I don't know, doesn't he? You're saying he can't be a paladin, Jerry?
I mean, he's basically the useless one, right?
Paladins aren't useless.
Exactly, that's why I can't be a paladin.
But that's totally, that should be a bit in Seinfeld the RPG.
Jerry, I want to be a paladin, come on! You can't be a paladin because paladins are useful to the party.
You saying I can't be useful to the party, Jerry?
I'm saying that maybe you should stick to what you're good at.
What am I good at, Jerry?
Oh, you know, you could stay in town, sell items. You could be an NPC. How do you feel about that, George?
But I want to go on an adventure, Jerry.
Oh, you know who the mid boss would be
who?
For that game?
The
Newman.
Newman.
Newman. I kind of want that to be a game now.
Yeah, the Seinfeld RPG.
Yeah. How the fuck did I survive those?
Save! We're gonna get back to town, and we're gonna stop.
Good thing there's a shortcut.
There are three more gonna come out here. We're gonna jump roping. Save. Yeah. Before you take a step.
You know what was funny? The guy who did the speed run and
didn't save, I know.
Well,
you're not him.
No, he did save in that one. That wasn't his world record. He constantly had a guy with a whiteboard just telling him to save. He kept holding it up off screen. It was great.
You didn't save.
It's fine. I didn't die, so. Down to the right. Alright, that makes sense.
Seinfeld really is like Always Sunny, but targeted a slightly older audience.
Yeah. Ah! It tricked me!
At least you saved.
Always Sunny is targeted towards the same audience, I feel.
I guess. It's more modern, it's for. I want to say, like, the characters in Always Sunny are younger than the Seinfeld characters.
The characters in Always Sunny are more malicious than the characters in Seinfeld.
Well, yeah, it's a more cynical show, slightly.
Seinfeld on crack. Did I save? No! Like,
Seinfeld was a 90s show.
Stop talking about Seinfeld while we're getting gang-fucked by every fire creature under the sun.
Seinfeld was a 90s show. Always Sunny is markedly a 2000s show.
Yeah, that's true. Okay, let's try
9/11
this.
9/11 changed everything. Boing, boing,
somebody
boing.
Actually did write a fucking, a 9/11 Seinfeld episode.
Yeah.
Where, like, what? It was, like, in such good, like...
Good, you're learning.
I'm not gonna say it was in good taste or anything, I'm just gonna say that it was, Hey, we're out!
Oh, it goes straight out. That's convenient.
Yeah, because they know that this cave is bullshit.
Don't want to do that platforming. Double save, just to be really sure.
Oh, by the way, wind works out here. So I could actually just grind out here and be fine. We're gonna come back, and then I'm just gonna be level 50.
Flying is very effective against rock.
Yeah.
In case you just weren't aware of that fact, Pidgeotto trounces Brock with sand attack.
Let's just get to the fucking. Let's just go home. Let's go back to town. Rest up. We'll get the. I'll get the item that's needed to get to the boss, and then we can. What's the next? And then we'll get to the next dungeon after the boss, which is polar. I'm gonna give you a hint. Polar opposite of the dungeon we're at now.
Wait, I zoned out, what?
What? You zoned out? How dare you?
We're gonna go to town and stop, right?
We're gonna go to town. I'm gonna get the key item needed to get to the boss, because I don't want to forget to do that and go all the way down to the fucking dwarf fortress.
Oh, we're gonna get the key and then stop.
Yes.
Okay. I bet the wolves are weak to wind too, right?
They're much. It's a much stronger move in general.
They hate fire. They're super like resistant to fire. It doesn't even affect them. But dogs hate like their face being blown in. Dogs get really mad when you do that.
Yeah. All right. So.
Even though they love sticking their face out the car window.
They don't like, it's razor wind. Oh, that's not what I, he doesn't give a shit about the mirror. Alternatively, I don't want to kill him.
What about a monk, Jerry? I can fight things with my fists.
Oh god, he could be a monk.
Just, or a berserker.
He looks like a monk.
Or a berserker, I'll have one arm that's like possessed. Isn't that cool?
It's so tiring. I want to rest. What's so tiring, guy?
It would be funny if every time you died, the Seinfeld intro played. I think he just described how I'm going to edit this video.
Are you really gonna? I hope you do.
No highlights, maybe.
Oh, this is the legendary moonstone. It's shining nobly. I'm glad I'm alive. He was gonna kill himself if he didn't see the moonstone.
Okay.
I want to give you this as a token of my appreciation.
My life is now complete. Bleh.
Freezing pot!
Don't you usually burn it? Sorry, blaze it.
can open the entrance blocked by lava. How do you know this, guy?
Was there an entrance blocked by lava?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't see
it. It confused me the fuck out, too.
Okay.
Well, I'll show it to you.
Is that puddle bubbling, by the way?
Nah, it's just more dirty water.
Oh.
Well, that's,
don't want to walk in puddles, you'll ruin your boots.
That's the end of, that run.
You can walk in, you can walk over lava, but not over puddles.
You're not supposed to, it deals damage to you.
Oh.
So what we got through Phillips, Castle of Phillips.
Yeah, we beat CDI Castle.
Rescued some elves, got the key of Phillips, defeated a
Chimera
thing.
We defeated Nutella.
With Nutella.
Nutella is slain.
Got a sword, which, got two more swords. Got through a desert.
Got wind magic.
Retrieved a pendant for asshole boyfriend Thor. And,
went through lava cave, did platforming.
Got a moonstone, and then got a freezing pot needed to get to the boss.
And got wind magic and saved a lot. And Seinfeld. All, so, a good streak.
All in all, that was very eventful despite the fact that we needed a map.
Always double save, boys and girls.
Yep, well, you gotta be sure. If you're not sure you're safe, save.
Well, it's been over a couple hours, so sorry.
Has it really been that long?
I'm sure. Right. I mean, we did Spyro, too.
That's true.
20 minutes.
Yeah.
So, sorry we're not going longer. Thank you for tuning in.
Check out our YouTube channel where all our streams are saved in case you missed some.
Shameless plug. See you next time.
See you next time.